An asteroid is going to zip past the Earth on Friday, the 13th of April in 2029, so close that it will be possible to spot it with your own eyes. That asteroid is Apophis, and today I'm breaking down everything you need to know about its next near miss and why scientists are paying extra attention. Now, while most asteroids chill out in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, some like to live a little dangerously. They're called near-Earth asteroids, and their orbits bring them close to us, sometimes uncomfortably close. The reasons why near-Earth asteroids could pose a threat start with the fact that their orbits are unpredictable. Their paths are shaped by gravitational nudges from planets, as well as a thing called the Yarkovsky effect. That's where heat from the sun can slowly change an asteroid's orbit over time. It arises from the uneven way an asteroid absorbs and then re-emits sunlight as heat. This makes it tricky to know exactly where they'll be far into the future. As a result of this trickiness, scientists predict the risks these asteroids pose to Earth using scales like the Torino and Palermo scales that calculate the odds of an impact and what kind of damage it might do. As for Apophis, it's currently a zero on both the Torino and Palermo scales, but it wasn't always like that. In fact, since its discovery by astronomers at Kitt Peak National Observatory in 2004, its story has been quite the roller coaster ride. It was first spotted on the 19th of June in 2004, and by December of the same year, calculations showed that there was a 1 in 37 chance, or a 2.7% chance, of Apophis smacking into Earth in 2029. That may sound small, but when it comes to potential asteroid impacts, that's an eye-wateringly high chance. At this point, Apophis hit a level 4 on the Torino scale. This was the highest level ever recorded for any asteroid, so naturally the media and public went wild with concern. But then, almost as quickly as fear was struck, it dissipated in late December when astronomers found something that changed the game, a pre-recovery image of Apophis from March 2004. With this extra information, this allowed astronomers to ultimately rule out the possibility of an impact in 2029. Who says it like that? 2029. Okay, but what about the keyholes? This is a common question I get asked when talking about Apophis and its 2029 flyby. Before 2006, there was a small possibility that Apophis could pass through a gravitational keyhole, a small region in space near the Earth that could alter the path of Apophis in such a way that it would lead to an impact in 2036. But by August 2006, continued observations showed promising news, dropping the 2036 impact risk to zero on the Torino scale. And by 2008, astronomers had narrowed down the size of the proposed keyholes to be less than 1 kilometer wide, making the odds of Apophis passing through it incredibly slim. I just got my mood alert cleared. Since then, more and more observations and analyses of new data officially eliminated any 2036 impact possibilities, even for the close encounter following that in 2068. And with that, by March 2021, NASA even took Apophis off its Century Impact Risk Table, which catalogues potential future Earth impacts by asteroids and comets. Now, while the risk is low, astronomers haven't completely taken their eyes off Apophis. So let's take a closer look at what the latest research from Paul Wieger says about the potential threat of Apophis. They suggest that if Apophis gets hit by a small, unknown asteroid between now and 2029, that could set it on a course to eventually impact Earth. Before I get into it further, here's the bottom line. The probability of a small asteroid impacting Apophis and altering its trajectory enough to send it on a collision course with Earth is extremely low. According to recent calculations by Wieger, the chance of such an event is less than 1 in 1,000,000 for a deflection that could lead to a future collision in the next century. And when it comes to potential impacts causing a collision with Earth in 2029, the odds are even slimmer, at less than 1 in 1,000,000,000. So the risk is practically non-existent. Now, if a small asteroid were to strike Apophis, astronomers could potentially detect it by tracking any deviation in its predicted path. Such an impact might also cause Apophis to brighten slightly, which could be a nice visual clue for observers. But there is a bit of a challenge, a hurdle, if you will, when it comes to monitoring Apophis and any potential changes in its trajectory at the moment. Because Apophis hasn't been observed since May 2021, and it won't be again until 2027 because it's currently very close to the position of the sun in the sky. So it's a bit difficult to know whether Apophis has been hit by a small unknown asteroid that could alter its trajectory towards Earth, but at least the chances are small, right? Right? Now, while that may or may not have eased your nerves about the upcoming close encounter with Apophis, here are three things we can look forward to when it comes around. Firstly, it's going to be stupidly close. Not impact close, as we've discussed, but still close. It's going to be 10 times closer than the Moon at an estimated distance of 31,600 kilometers with an uncertainty of 3.4 kilometers. That's closer than geosynchronous satellites, the kind of satellites that broadcast TV, radio, and other telecommunications. These satellites typically orbit at around 35,786 kilometers above the Earth's surface, over 4,000 kilometers further than Apophis's closest approach. But don't worry, it is still very unlikely that Apophis will actually hit or even influence the orbits of these satellites because of their relative positions around the Earth at the time. But since it will be so close, it will actually be visible to the naked eye for some parts of the world. That's the second thing to look forward to, seeing an asteroid with the unaided eye. If you're in Australia, Southern Asia, Southern Europe, or Africa, you're in for a treat. You'll have the best view of Apophis when it's at its brightest. If you're in a dark suburban area, or even better, a rural area, you should be able to spot it with the naked eye. Now, I will be honest, it might be a little underwhelming because it will just look like another star, but just a touch brighter than the fifth star of the Southern Cross for those familiar with the Southern Hemisphere stars. And for those in the Northern Hemisphere, it'll be about one magnitude fainter than the North Star Polaris. Now, it will be moving slightly, but you probably won't notice it too much over the course of a few minutes. For comparison, it will definitely appear to travel slower than visible satellites. But over the course of the night, it will definitely change position drastically, which is the exciting part. You're seeing an asteroid with your own eyes. As it moves further from Earth and starts to dim, it will become visible in eastern South America, and for those on the east coast of North America, as evening sets in, you'll be able to spot Apophis through a telescope in the night sky. And finally, since it will be so close to Earth, we'll be able to study it closely even with space probes. Remember the OSIRIS-REx mission? That's the asteroid sample return mission that initially went to the asteroid Bennu, which, by the way, unlike Apophis, is actually listed on NASA's Sentry Risk Table with currently the second highest cumulative rating on the Palermo scale, with 157 potential impacts to look out for at the moment. Anyway, back to Apophis though. After the OSIRIS-REx mission returned its asteroid sample back to Earth, it is now renamed to the OSIRIS-APEX mission and redirected to get nice and close to Apophis during its 2029 Earth flyby. During this mission, scientists in the OSIRIS-APEX team hope to investigate the effects of Earth's gravity on Apophis as it flies by, specifically looking at the way it rotates and how that changes, and potentially whether Earth's tidal forces will cause any changes to the surface of Apophis. And lastly, while OSIRIS-APEX won't be attempting to deflect Apophis, its close flyby gives us a rare chance to observe how Earth's gravity naturally influences its path. So as you can see, we've been on quite the journey with Apophis, from its discovery and early fears of a potential impact to the reassurance that we're safe from any collision for at least the next century. While we don't have to worry about Apophis hitting us, this flyby is a rare opportunity to learn more about near-Earth asteroids and how they're shaped by the forces around them. The data we gather could one day even help us protect our planet from future threats. The universe always has a way of keeping things interesting, and Apophis is no exception. So keep an eye on the skies, because 2029 is shaping up to be an exciting year for science. Stay curious and keep looking up.